Hey guys,
my name is Kuyanche, and welcome to episode 6 of my Applied Energistics 2 tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. This episode will be a short one, where we'll be discussing both the portable cell and the cell workbench. So let's get started. So first of all is the portable cell. Like the name would suggest, the portable cell is pretty much like an ME chest, which you can carry around at all times. As you can see, when you hover over it, you can see that it can only store 512 bytes at only 27 types. So it is quite a toned down version of an ME chest or ME network or however you want to look at it. Do keep in mind it also requires power, so you will need to charge it to use it. So what you need to do is simply hold this in your inventory and right click. And you will see that it pretty much acts like an ME interface where you're able to actually dump items in just like so. And again, you can configure it by either name, sort order, and NEI synchronized searching. So that is pretty nice. Do keep in mind that it uses power just while being open. So yeah, that's definitely something you want to keep in mind. But it also uses a little bit of extra power every time you take items in or out. So yes, keep that in mind. But other than that, pretty cool item. Next up is the cell workbench. The cell workbench is a block that allows you to pretty much format the drives that you put in it to only allow a specific amount of items to be stored in that drive. For example, it can be very useful when you have different tier drives in your network, where you want the high tier drives to only be used by items you use very often. So, or have a very huge amount of, for example, things like ores or dirt, cobblestone, all that stuff. And use the lower tier drives for only things that you have a lot of small things for. Because ME systems aren't smart enough on their own to decide where they want to put the stuff. So as you can see, this is how the interface looks like when you open it. Pretty much three buttons on the right and one slot in the top right. So pretty much what you can do is hit or put a drive in it, either a storage cell or a portable cell that is. And you can see there are two more slots that open up right here. These are pretty much for upgrade cards, there are only two cards in normal Applied Energistics 2 without any add-ons that can go in here, either the inverter card and the fuzzy card. The fuzzy card being pretty much checks less consistent, or how should I put this, less strict when you put something in. So for example, if I were to put the fuzzy card in and set it to oakwood planks, it set this thing to match any fuzzy comparison. As you can see, now I put this in, it has been formatted. As you can also see, when you hover over it, partitions included fuzzy, meaning that the fuzzy card is inserted. Then all you need to do is simply put it into your ME drive. You will see that it is orange, meaning that it is either maxed out of types or it is partitioned. So keep that in mind. And then that means that I'm only able to put wood in. So in this case, both the type of planks will go in because I set it to fuzzy. But if I would have removed that card, the other type of wood that I didn't specify won't be able to go in. So for example right here, I'm shift-clicking dirt and I can't place it in, either left-clicking or whatever. It simply won't go in because there is no space for it, as this drive is partitioned to only allow that block. Pretty cool. So again, if I would remove the partition or the fuzzy card and only have the oakwood plank in this thing, let me quickly put the drive back. You'd see it would allow the oakwood planks, but the spruce wood won't go in now either. Pretty useful, if you ask me. Then there is one more card, which is the inverter card, which pretty much does exactly as you would guess. If you add the inverter card, pretty much all the items that you add won't be allowed to go in, and all the other items will be allowed. So again, put it back into your network. Now, if I did it correctly, everything but these oakwood planks are allowed to go in. Do keep in mind that the partition won't take effect if the items are already in there. So as you saw a moment ago, the wood planks were still in the network, and that's allowed. But once I've taken it out, I won't be able to place it back in. So again, not taking it in, but all the other items are allowed to go in. So pretty cool. Then there are a couple more buttons on the left, which are just for your sake. Either you can hit the clear button, which clears the entire, pretty much the entire partition. The partition storage button, which specifies the partition on the items that are currently in this thing. So if I were to add this drive again to my network, put all these items in here, take it out again, and then hit format or partition storage, you would see all five of the items that I added into the cell are now added to the partition. Then there's also the copy mode, which pretty much controls if the contents of the configuration pane are cleared where you move the actual cell. So that's, yeah, just like you can see right here. If you want to have multiple cells with the same settings, pretty cool. And that's pretty much it for this video, guys. Again, if you have any suggestions, like always, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below. I always read all my comments and I really like to get you guys' feedback on my videos, because together we make this an awesome educational and entertaining series. So thanks for watching, please leave a rating, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.